فعاش القلب إخلاصا وصرت تحوم كالطير تحلق في ثقافات وتنهل من ربى الخير.
نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له هو رب العالمين، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله وخيرته من خلقه صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى الآل والصحب الكرام. أما بعد، فاتقوا الله عباد الله، واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله، ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. My beloved brothers, sisters and children in Islam, firstly we remind each other of where we came from, where we are and where we are heading. Anyone who does not think about this is actually foolish, because before we came into this world, we were somewhere. Now we know that we are on earth, and we also do know that we will not last forever on earth. Just like those before us have left, and they have left at different ages, because death knows no age. It does not mean that only the old go. We know some of our friends and colleagues, some of the young and the old, who have passed on. So it would be foolish for a person not to consider the fact that one day we're going to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We came from Allah, we shall be returning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He has kept us on earth for a purpose. That purpose is to be able to fulfill this life that He has chosen for us. He has determined the duration of, in a way that will not displease Him. So my beloved children, my brothers, my sisters, try your best never to displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because in that way you will be preparing for the day you meet Him. When you meet Him, you can tell Him, "Oh Allah, I tried never to displease You." And He may say to you in return, "I forgive you completely and grant you the best of the hereafter, and that is Jannatul Firdaus, or Paradise." We are believers. We do believe that when we die, we will be questioned about everything that we have done while we were in this particular life or on earth. And therefore, we should be conscious of Allah. It is called Taqwa Allah. فَإِنَّ مَنِ اتَّقَ اللَّهَ وَقَاهُ. Whoever is conscious of Allah, Allah will save them from calamity and hardship in this world and the next. So my beloved children, I give you an example. When I was young, I remember reading the verse of the Quran where Allah says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Allah says, "I have not created mankind or jinnkind except for them to worship Me." And I was very young. I used to think to myself, or I thought to myself for a moment, that this is quite boring. If that's the case and I need to stand in salah 24 hours, or I need to be fasting, I need to be reading the Quran, because that's what worship means to me, then if Allah just made me so that I fulfill salah and I fast and I just read Quran and I continue in the dhikr of Allah, when am I going to play? When am I going to go out and do some, have a bit of fun? When am I going to be able to, for example, eat and drink? When am I going to be able to sleep? And then I was corrected. I was corrected that Allah does not mean that you should continue 24/7 in prayer or in fasting or in the recitation of the Quran. But what He means when He says you should lead your life in a way that you're worshipping Him, do not go against His commands. Whatever you do, make sure that you have fulfilled what the Almighty wants from you, and lead your life in a way that does not go against the requirement that He has laid down. And then I was quite satisfied. I realized that when I go to play, if I have a good intention and I know that I want to, for example, be with my friends, we want to do something that is not prohibited. We want to perhaps engage in clean fun. Remember the word. We want to engage in clean fun and perhaps laugh together, smile together, and remind each other of the Almighty together in a way that when the time of prayer comes, we set aside the game and we say our prayer. If the time of the prayer comes, we set aside what we're doing and we say our prayer. That means you have worshipped Allah. You have understood why Allah has brought you onto the earth, and you are doing what is not in the transgression of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We may want to go out to eat, for example, on condition that we are going to a place where the food will be halal. So I'm not compromising what Allah has asked me not to compromise. And at the same time, if I were to go into an environment that would be pleasing to Allah, and Allah knows my intention is that I don't want to go against His command, wallahi, He will give you a reward for it. So in the same way that to do something Allah requires you to do is an act of worship, to stay away from something Allah does not want you to do is also an act of worship. Remember that. So if you don't swear, you are in an act of worship. If you were tempted to do something bad and you did not do it, you get a reward because you kept yourself away, knowing that had I done it, I would have displeased Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my beloved children, let us understand that if it was not for the knowledge that Allah has bestowed upon us, we would be ignorant. People say, and I've heard people say this, young people say, Islam is a religion that's very difficult. In reality, it is because of ignorance and because of the fact that you don't have enough knowledge that you feel that it's difficult, but in essence, it is not. It is not at all difficult. It is the beauty of the life of this world at its peak as you embrace what the Almighty wants from you. What does He want from you? He wants you to be a clean person. No drinking, no dirty behavior, no abusive language, no gambling, no, for example, immoral behavior. When we dress, it should be respectful. It should be filled with values and morals. The highest of them should be ours. That's what Allah wants from us. So we actually have been given such a beautiful set of rules and regulations that if we were to understand them and adopt them, we would become upright individuals. Imagine, no drinking, no smoking, no drugs, never. If you are to follow that, you would actually be the best of people. You would be an upright person, intelligent. You would be someone who can achieve. You would not be wasting your money on cigarettes. You wouldn't be wasting your money on drugs or on the nightlife or on gambling, etc. This is what Islam teaches you, to be upright. So if you were to follow the deen of Islam in the correct sense, it would automatically qualify you to leadership. It would make you a person who is qualified to be a leader. You can lead, people will look up to you because you have good qualities. You have high values and the standard of your morals extremely high. You would be a person people look up to because you are straight. The chances of your success are far greater than those who dilly-dally and sway with the wind. When they see others doing bad, they do it because they would feel left out if they didn't. So Islam says, don't do that. Even if you feel left out, when you know what is right, it's okay. So long as you are pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so long as you are not involved in something bad, something evil, something harmful, something hurtful, something that is totally wrong. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a deep understanding. My beloved children, remember, you need to increase your knowledge. Just like when you are in grade 1, you want to go to grade 2. From grade 2, no one would like to remain there, we'd like to go to grade 3. And if you're extremely intelligent, in very rare cases, they might allow you to jump a whole year. I'm sure you've heard of some of these cases where a person jumps from grade 3 to grade 5. Why? They were super intelligent and they worked extremely hard. Like I said, extremely rare. But we've heard of such cases. We would love to do this, but remember, my beloved children, in the same way that you want to achieve the best of results for your secondary school, for your primary school, in the same way that you want to go into the university of your choice and you want to follow the subjects, or you want to go through to the faculty of your choice in the universities, so therefore you work hard, you need to work equally hard to be able to qualify to get into the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the day you return to Him. So therefore, don't forget your duty unto Allah. Don't compromise your prayer, no matter what. Do not compromise your prayer. You may be the top doctor in the country. You may be the best of the psychiatrists in the country. You may be a beautiful and a lovely sportsman, sportsperson, subhanAllah. But don't compromise your link with Allah by letting your salah and your prayer go by and you not even feeling within you that you had an obligation. May Allah make us conscious of this beautiful, beautiful gift that He has bestowed upon us. Did you know that Salah was given as a gift to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam upon the Mi'raj? It was a gift. And it's amazing how today we do not consider it a gift. Sometimes we feel lazy and you don't realize Allah has given it to you in order to help you to become the best of people. You will be disciplined, you will achieve closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your day will be made. But sadly, what overtakes us today is laziness. We become lazy at the wrong time. When we're supposed to be getting up, we become lazy. When we're supposed to be doing, for example, even something that may not be strictly religious. Like I told you, if you have the correct intention, you will get a reward for it. When you enter the classroom, if you have a good intention, no matter what the subject is, you achieve a reward for it because you have a good intention. I would like to become a doctor. I'm a Muslim and I would like to serve humanity in a way, if Allah allows me, I can save lives. And if you were to save lives, Allah will reward you because Allah created those lives. Remember this. So if your intention is correct, no matter what subject you are in, it may be mathematics, it may be geography, it may be physics or biology, you are definitely heading in the right direction, earning a reward and gaining closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because your intention is correct. I'm studying these subjects so that I can become the best of, like I said, doctors. And so when you become the doctor, what will you be? You will actually be a very good Muslim who stands up proud and serving the rest of humanity in such a beautiful way, subhanAllah. That is what we need. If you are a sports person, take a look at those names of people whom perhaps have achieved in the sports field, yet they are Muslims. Did you know a lot of them do not compromise their salah? Did you know that? A lot of them are very good Muslims in the sense that they read the Quran on a daily basis. They're inspired by a good word. They try their best to behave in a beautiful way. Personally, I have met so many of them and I'm inspired by the fact that not only have they excelled on the sports field, but they are beautiful Muslims. I hope that we can all be inspired by such people, that no matter what you achieve, no matter where you want to go, no matter where you are heading, you never forget who you are, where you've come from, and where you are heading. May Allah make it easy for us the day we meet Him. May we be proud of what we will forward to Him. Because the day we meet with Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, all our deeds will be packaged in a certain way. And we will take that package and present it in front of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. What type of a package do you want to take? Do you want to take a package filled with drugs? A package filled with dirty behavior? A package filled with abusive tongues? A package filled with that which is evil? Or would you like to take a package filled with goodness? Filled with the fact that we were trying our best while we were on earth? Filled with the fact that we fulfilled the purpose that Allah made us for? We all want a good package. Imagine you're going to meet with Allah, and your deeds and whatever you did on earth are going to be taken in the form of a certain type of package. Who would like a bad package? None of us. If you have done something wrong, You know, the way out is to seek forgiveness of Allah. We say Allah is the most merciful, Allah is the most forgiving. And indeed, the Prophet, peace be upon him, has told us that Allah is so merciful that he will forgive you until the point of gharqa. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبِلُ تَوْبَةَ الْعَبْلِ مَا لَمْ يُغَرْقِ. Allah continues to accept the repentance of his slaves for as long as they have not got to the point of their final death. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us these. So, I plead with you to fight off laziness. Because it is with laziness and distractions that we tend to lose. We do not perform well, neither at school, nor at home, nor in our social circles, and not even in our spiritual or religious lives. Yet, they are all somewhat integrated. My brothers, my sisters, my children, it's important for us to realize that being disciplined and being able to know the timings for different things plays a big role in determining your success. If you don't have a sense of time, you will not be able to succeed. Look at a football match. How long is it? Perhaps 90 minutes. It might go into a little bit of overtime, but they don't lose track of time just because they're enjoying the match. What we do with our phones today is when we pick them up, we lose track of time. 2 hours go by, 4 hours go by, 6 hours go by, because there is something interesting, our match continues. Wow. Well, guess what? Your game, you have been disqualified, because that's not a proper game. If you really want to enjoy, you need to have a fixed time. You need to make sure that, look, I'm going to play my game, I'm going to do something I enjoy, but just for 1 hour. After that, I'm going to do something, I might feel a little bit lazy sometimes, but I'm going to push myself. My children, if you don't push yourself to do good, Shaitan will continue to just massage you into the bad lane. And then what will you achieve? Nothing. Look what happens to some of us. We don't study. We wait until the exams. The last day, we're awake all night. And then the following morning we come, and we think we've learned everything, and we have dizzy spells as we see the papers. When the question is 1 plus 1, because you haven't had sleep, you're reading 11 plus 11. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. Instead of that, space out your study. Study through the year, through the term, have a time, have study groups. Make sure that you fight laziness, because if you don't fight that laziness, and if you're not dedicated and disciplined, you will not be able to achieve. I hope and I pray that these few words have actually inspired us to fight off laziness, to be able to be disciplined, to be able to be focused, and to work towards achieving that goal. For indeed, those who have achieved, go and ask them how they've achieved. They have achieved through hard work, effort, dedication. Even the sportsmen and those on the sports field are men and women, subhanallah. They have worked hard, they have trained every single day. They are disciplined in what they eat, in where they go and what they do. And that is why they achieve. So remember, if you are not going to be serious, you will not be able to achieve. If you'd like to achieve in this world and the next, let's become more serious and let's take everything a little bit more seriously. Yes, you will play, you will enjoy, but all that within limits. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all. أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ جَوَادٌ كَرِيمٌ. الحمد لله الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله إمام المتقين ورسول رب العالمين الذي بعث إلى الناس كافة بعث إلى الأحمر والأسود وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن سلك طريقهم وسار على نهجهم واقتفى أثرهم إلى يوم الدين اللهم اجعلنا منهم أما بعد فاتقوا الله عباد الله واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ولا تزر وازرة وزر أخرى، ثم إلى ربكم مرجعكم فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون. أحبتي في الله، الكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت، والعاجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله. صلوا وسلموا يرحمكم الله على النبي المصطفى والحبيب المجتبى كما أمركم بذلك ربكم جل وعلا. قال عز وجل: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم فصل وسلم وبارك وأنعم على عبدك ورسولك محمد أفضل الخلق وأكرم الرسل، ورضى اللهم عن خلفائه الراشدين الأئمة المهديين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي. اللهم ارض عنهم وعن سائر الصحابة والتابعين وعنا معهم بمنك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم آمنا في أوطاننا، وأصلح أئمتنا وولاة أمورنا، واجعل ولايتنا في من خافك واتقاك واتبع رضاك يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر الذين أخرجوا من ديارهم بغير حق إلا أن يقولوا ربنا الله. اللهم انصر المظلومين في كل مكان، اللهم إنك أنت أعلم بالظالم والمظلوم، فانصر المظلوم على الظالم يا قوي يا عزيز يا جبار السماوات والأرضين، يا صاحب كل نجوى ويا منتهى كل شكوى. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين، وارحم موتانا وموت المسلمين، وارحمنا إذا صرنا إلى ما صاروا إليه. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أكبر. وأقيموا الصلاة، يرحمكم الله عز وجل.